Hello all, welcome to another session on VLSI design. So previous session we have covered something like subsystem design and layout. So and we discussed regarding architectural issues and something like clocked or unclocked logic circuits, something like static CMOS circuits and some ratioed logic. Okay, so right now in the previous session that when we discussed the static CMOS circuits, we had some advantages from static CMOS circuits. At the same time, we had some something like ratioed logics, that is pseudo NMOS circuits. So we had later certain advantages and disadvantages there. So when you go for static CMOS circuits, so we had something like we need to realize twice the functionality. So in case of pull up network also and pull down network also. That is the situation, but the advantage is there is no static power dissipation in that. So when there is no static power dissipation, that means so it can be taken as a thing for a low power devices. At the same time, when we go for pseudo NMOS device, so pseudo NMOS device is actually having a faster, so than almost 4 to 5 times faster than your static CMOS circuits. So because the capacitance is less, so since there is only realizing the pull down network only, so you no need to implement the functionality twice. So only one pull down network will be implemented and pull up will be only one transistor PMOS. So the capacitance will come down. At the same time, the same will actually in turn increase your performance in terms of speed. Okay, so we now we have both things here. So if you need speed, we can choose pseudo NMOS device. At the same time, if you need something low power thing, so then we can go for static CMOS. So how do we can get the best of the both worlds? So we need the best of the both worlds. So we'll try to understand, and we'll try to go for how we can just exploit the advantages of both and turn into the other circuits. Okay, so get the benefit of both. Okay, so here we will discuss something like dynamic logic circuits, so which will be a clocked one. So those two things are non-clocked, they are not clocked one, but so we'll go to give for clocked one, that we call as a dynamic circuits. So let's go for it. Right, so this is something like introduction part here. What are dynamic circuits? So as said before, so the advantages of low power static CMOS circuits are nothing but a smaller chip area, okay, of NMOS circuits. So these two things are combined. So this actually having a larger chip area because two times functionality has to be realized. And for NMOS circuits, that is nothing but pseudo NMOS circuits, so we have less chip area because it's only pull down network will be used for it. And we'll try to combine these both advantages and we'll make something like a concept of dynamic circuits will be arriving. Okay, so this is going to lead you something like a smaller area. At the same time, we'll have the advantages of static CMOS circuit, that is low power dissipation. So this is something like the static combination circuit, which have large capacitance that I discussed right now, that is going to have a larger delay. So it's going to have something like poor performance of the circuit, which is actually a not desirable one. So we need performance, we need a good speed also. Okay. And so these dynamic MOS circuits are realized by using the parasitic capacitance. Okay. So to store the information. So this we'll see in something like dynamic RAM. So this we'll discuss in the fifth module. And probably you are already using so many cell phones or laptops, and you have heard of something like RAM. Okay, so those RAMs usually the earlier case, something like 2000, something like that, 1990, something like all those. At that time, we had something like SD RAM, that is static RAM were there. Okay, so now we have something like dynamic RAM, we call as DRAM. Okay, so there are so many improvements have been taken place, so than your basic concept. So we can just see that your day-to-day life, so you'll be using that, discussing something like RAM, 6 GB RAM, 6 GB RAM, 8 GB RAM, 64 GB storage, something like that. So in that case, you can say those are something like DRAMs, okay, dynamic RAMs. Okay, and so you're already getting something like LPDDR, then low power DDR. So we have some DDR3, DDR4, so like that. So okay, so coming to this, so dynamic MOS circuits, so we will try to extract whatever the load capacitance we had earlier, because one circuit, so from one gate to another gate, we discuss something like gate capacitance. So this directly discussed in sheet resistance and capacitance lecture video. Okay, so that capacitance, load capacitance is actually is the combination of your gate to substrate capacitance, source to substrate capacitance, and your drain to substrate capacitance. So these all combinations we call as that load capacitance. And those capacitance what you are getting in gate capacitance is very good in nature. Okay, so very good in nature because of that silicon dioxide present in there. So because of silicon dioxide, you're getting that capacitance. So here what we will do is we will try to exploit that particular capacitance, and we will try to use that capacitance as a storage. Okay, and that storage usage of that particular capacitance, so lead to the evolution of these dynamic circuits. Okay, so we'll see how this can be utilized in the next further slides. Okay, so here, so that is one thing. So you're going to use this parasitic capacitance present at the node, and you will make something like to store the information. And so pseudo NMOS logic overcomes the delay issues, right? So I told you it's speed, 4 to 5 times speed, faster than your static CMOS. But the only thing is the PMOS transistors fight against NMOS during the falling transistors. Okay, so logic one is good, but when you go for logic zero, so you'll get something like poor logic zero output because there is a fight between your VDD and ground. So there is a short path will be there. You will have something like static power dissipation there. So this static power dissipation is going to make your output low, not a weak signal, so not a strong signal. So that's the thing. So this is going to is going to affect something like the rising time, the fall time will be affected. Right, so that is the thing. And so the alternate way, what you will do is you will try to alter this pseudo NMOS logic. Okay, so we will try to alter the pseudo NMOS logic. Instead of grounding your PMOS transistor in a pull-up device to ground, so what I will do is I will try to introduce a clock there. Okay, so I will introduce the connected clock to the input to the PMOS transistor. So that topology, what you're going to get, so that topology is actually nothing but your dynamic logic circuits. Okay, that we call as a dynamic circuits or dynamic gate. Right, so hope you understand this part. So we'll go to the next slide. Right, so this is what I just explained. So this will be your NOR gate. I already shown you the previous same example for your pseudo NMOS logic. So here the pseudo NMOS logic is your for NOR gate. So 4 input NAND gate you realize this is your pull down network realized using NMOS transistors. You know this, how do you write these things. So this is a discussed stick diagram concept, and you will have 1 PMOS device. So you are going to ground this gate of the PMOS device so that that becomes pseudo NMOS. Okay, so now instead of grounding this, what I will do is the same circuit, instead of grounding, I'm going to apply a clock signal. So we call it a phi here. Okay, this is a clock signal I'm going to use now. Okay, and when this clock is there, so there is a concept we are going to study here. So where we have a something like a new concepts. We have a state called precharge and evaluate phase. Okay, so we'll have a clock like this, so 0 1 0 1 like this. So we will take whenever the phi is actually zero value, that is zero level of the clock, so that clock range is actually we call as a precharge phase. Okay, and when clock becomes one, so that actually we call as a evaluate phase. So basically what we are doing is once this is my circuit, and we will have something like right, so we will have something like this will be connected to the next circuit. Okay, so in between you will have some capacitance here, right? So in this particular node, so this capacitance what we are having, so this will be charged. Okay, so this will be connected to VDD. So whenever phi is zero, that is your this phi is zero, that is precharge phase. So this output node load, that is gate capacitance of the next stage, this load is charged to VDD. Okay, right, this charged to VDD, we call that phase as a precharge phase. Okay, so then after precharge phase, when clock will becomes one, so then the actual circuit will be evaluated. Okay, that is we call as a evaluate phase. Then whatever the depending upon your input combinations here, so whether this input combination, the values of A and B and C and D, is going to make your output node either to stay at remain at VDD or to ground it. Okay, suppose in this condition, so assume that this transistor is actually pre-charged your output to logic 1. Okay, so now your A, B, C, D, all values are zeros means, so what will happen? So all these transistors will be off. So when all transistors will be off, so there is no connection from this node to ground. So this VDD stays the same way, right? So this is the output you are going to get. Okay, so if any one of the inputs is going to make high, if A is equal to 1 means, so there exists a path here. So then the output, whatever VDD is charged, so it will be grounded. So output becomes low. Okay, so the thing is very simple. So in this circuit, we are going to charge your output node, pre-charge your node to VDD first, and depending upon your circuit combinations, what expressions you are realizing. So if the expression's output is 1, so anyhow output is already 1, it stays at 1. So if the expression of output result is actually going to be 0, so then this will be discharged to 0. So this is the how we are going to evaluate this particular thing. Okay, this is the pre-charge and evaluate. Okay, so I think and you understood these things. I will go for next slide. Right, so another concept we have to take care here is the pre-charge rule is actually the dynamic gate, that there should be no active path to ground during the pre-charge. Okay, that means, so this is my circuit we discussed in the previous slide, the dynamic circuit. So in this case, so assume that, so if in the phase when phi is equal to 0, that is clock is equal to 0, this particular node whatever here you are having is going to be pre-charged to VDD. So while pre-charging, in that when phi is equal to 0, so we should maintain that, so no transistor should turn on because it's not evaluate phase, we are not evaluating any output. So in that case, when during pre-charge says, so there should not be any short circuit to the ground. Okay, so that we should take care of in this particular circuit. And so many a time this is not possible, so we cannot guarantee that every time these things will not be turned on, or there is no short cut here. Okay, so leakage or something like that. So what we can do is we will try to add some extra clock here. So that means we will try to alter the circuit because this is my problem. So there should be no active path to the ground during the pre-charge. This is my problem, and we cannot keep it always, right? So what we will do is we will try to alter the circuit. We will try to insert below this another transistor, which is NMOS transistor. Okay, which is NMOS transistors, and we will apply same clock here. The same clock is going to, so this is circuit what I am telling for you. So we'll insert another transistor here. So what we'll do here, so we call it without foot and with foot. Okay, we he'll have some term for it. So here when same phi is given, so when phi is equal to 0, so this will turn on, PMOS will turn on, it is going to charge your capacitance to VDD, it is going to pre-charge it. At the same time, we already make sure here, because when phi is equal to 0, this NMOS transistor will be off, and no matter what is the condition of your ABCD, so it is not connected to ground. So this node will never be connected to ground. So that is then making sure that, so this no active path to ground. Okay, that makes sure inserting this transistor here makes sure that there is no active path to ground, right? So this is the concept. So we can say now this is the altered of your dynamic circuit. So these are some issues we faced. We are now this is my dynamic circuit or dynamic logic. Okay, right. So now so we can have what I've discussed anything but your this particular, this is the general structure we are shown here. So this is your general structure of dynamic circuits, one type, and this is another type. So you can do both. Okay, so here what I have done is I am using only pull down network, so I am taking output here. Okay, so everything remains same. So pull down network means we are using only NMOS transistors realizations, and if I try to use only pull up network realizations, so I will using pull up network means only PMOS device will be there here. Okay, so if you have something like AND gate A dot B, so NAND gate if you are trying to realize, so in that case what will happen? So here I'm going to have So NAND gate AB connected in whatever the logic here. So in the PMOS we'll be having here. So in this case PMOS, we are going to take your output at this instant. Okay. So this is for your pull down network dynamic circuits alone, and this is your if you are using pull up network alone. Okay. Right. So this is the one. This is your dynamic circuits, and there is an again issue with this. When we connect two dynamic circuits in cascade, okay, two dynamic circuits in cascade. So what will happen in this case? So here, so I'm having one dynamic circuit, okay. So I'm taking something like NOR gate. This is NOR operation, right? A plus B, so OR operation. Okay. So what will happen? So this again another dynamic circuits, okay. So these two are interconnected. Okay, the output of this particular circuit is driving the input of this particular circuit. Okay, so we already know how this dynamic circuit works. We'll have pre-charge phase and evaluate phase. So we'll try to analyze this particular circuit. So now when phi is equal to zero, that is nothing but pre-charge phase. This phi is equal to zero is your pre-charge phase, and in that case what will happen, this PMOS will turn on. Okay, and this PMOS will turn on and it is going to charge your node X. Here we will have capacitance, gate capacitance. So this node X will be charged to VDD, pre-charged to VDD. At the same time, we have this transistor also. So this will also turn on and it is going to charge your node Y to your output node Y to your VDD. So this is the case. So X and Y both will be charged to pre-charged to VDD. So you can see here. So when phi is equal to zero, X will also precharge to VDD and Y is also precharged to VDD. So the next stage, so phi will become 1. So when phi becomes 1, I forgot to say this. Obviously, this phi is equal to 0 means these two will be turned off. That you understand, I think, already. Okay, so we'll go for phi is equal to 1. When phi is equal to 1, this PMOS transistor will turn off. Okay, and this PMOS will be also turned off. So this NMOS and this NMOS will be turned on. Okay, that means so this particular circuit is also going into evaluate phase. At the same time, this particular circuit is also going to evaluate phase. So both are entering evaluate phase at the same time. And according to this, when you try to evaluate alone this particular circuit, so what can happen? So when phi is equal to 1, this will on. It's an evaluate phase. So when this is on, X is already precharged to VDD, and since my inputs are 1 here and 0 here, so 1 means this transistor will turn on. So that means there is a path from X to ground, because this is also turned on, right? So output node X is actually grounded. Okay, so output node is actually discharged through this one transistor, and the value of X will become 0. Okay, so right, so this is alone. So now, so the output of the circuit is actually 0. Okay, so now if you see this one, this circuit, what should happen? So the output of the circuit is 0, and since 0 is here, 0 should be here, and 0 should be here. So 0 0 means both will turn off, and as we know, this Y is already precharged to VDD and output should be high. This should be the case. So output should be high, should be the actual output. But what happens is, since this circuit is also evaluating the evaluation phase when this particular circuit is entered, so that case what will happen? So when this is start discharging, so this will also start evaluating. So in that case, this X node actually contains VDD value, so that means high value. So when this particular high value is taken as input for this, it will consider this as an input, and this will consider logic 1 here, and this will turn on. So when this will turn on, obviously this Y node will be grounded, so output Y becomes 0. Okay, so this is not the actual output we are expecting, so it's a wrong output, right? You can see, so when phi goes to high here, that is evaluation phase, X actually should go 0. This is not product, it's a correct one, but Y also evaluate to falls to 0. So this is the actual is going to happen in this circuit. Okay, so that means it's incorrect operation, right? So actually the output of Y should be high, as said before. So this is the issue we are facing here. So when we try to cascade your dynamic gates, okay, so how to overcome this problem? So my problem is, So when I'm doing precharge phase, this logic one, what we are having in the node, this is actually turning on this transistor. Okay, right? So during the precharge phase, this should not turn on. Okay, so since we are using only NMOS transistor, so NMOS transistors will only turn on if you give logic 1 as an input. Okay, so what I will do is I will try to insert an inverter here. Okay, so that even though this X is precharged, so this will give the after inverter, you're going to get logic 0 as an output. So the logic 0 means this devices will not turn on. Okay, so that keeping your the result properly. Okay, so that we'll see the next type, that we call as a domino logic. So to overcome this cascading issue problem what you're facing in dynamic gates, so we will try to go for alter the circuit, and that particular circuits we call as a domino logic. So this is your domino logic here. So you can see this is nothing but same dynamic circuit, only but only thing is I'm just adding extra inverter out here. That's it. So dynamic circuits with one inverter makes it domino logic. Okay, so now we can try to analyze now what happens here. Okay, the same circuit I'm going to have, the previous circuit only, but I'm actually adding here inverter. That's it. Okay, so now what we can analyze here. So if as usual, when phi is equal to 0, so A will be charged to VDD and C will be charged to VDD. So A will be charged to VDD and C will be charged to VDD. Okay, so now, so here the same inputs are applied as just as previous. So in the evaluate phase, that means when phi is equal to 1, so this will turn off, this will turn off, this will turn on. Okay, this is when this is nothing but evaluation phase. And when your 1 is there, that means this particular transistor is turned on. So A should be grounded. Okay, A should be grounded. And since we have 1 is there here, okay, logic 1 is there when during precharge phase, so that will make sure that the B will be 0 and this will not turn on. Okay, that's not the issue. Okay, so we are going to take this nothing but A will go 0. So then once A goes 0, so the inverter is nothing but your logic 1 here. So now logic 1 will actually make sure that this particular transistor will turn on and C will come down. Okay, when C will come down and it is going to be having another inverter outside, the actual D output will be logic 1. So what should be my output actually? Output should be actually Y should be logic 1, right? So the same thing is achieved here. Okay, so this how we can see the graph here. When the A is there in the precharge phase, so A will actually high, and that A high will actually triggers this inverter, and a B will actually go low. Okay, so at the same time, since B is going low, then this C is actually having high input. Okay, so this is the thing. So how this particular domino logic actually works. Okay, right. So we'll go for next particular topic. So here another thing is we can say yes, we are getting a proper output, no problem with that, but the thing is we need to have inverter, right? So we are having inverter means again we are actually adding extra circuitry here. So that's the problem, right? So we are actually adding another inverter here. That's actually adding another resources here, right? So can we try to eliminate adding this inverter and still try to solve the issues? Okay, so that is also possible. So that we call is going to achieve with using something like NP CMOS logic, or we call it a zipper logic. Okay, so that we'll discuss here, zipper logic or zipper CMOS, right? So what I will do is, so my problem is earlier was this one. So what my problem was, so when was it is when the X is actually pre-charged, this particular network will be turning on because this is NMOS circuits will be there. So NMOS will turn on when logic 1 comes to the gate. Okay, so I should make sure that when during pre-charge, this particular network should not turn on. Okay, so for that reason, what I will do, instead of having pull down network, why can't I use something like pull up network? So that actually I will make sure here, and So we will just have like this. So this will be your pull-down network dynamic circuits. And here, so instead of using your the same pull-down network dynamic circuits, I will use pull-up network dynamic circuits. Okay. So again, in this case, even though your output is VDD, since it is a PMOS network, so no transistor will turn on. Okay. So we are eliminating that issues we are facing. And after pull-up network, this output, if you have another stage here, so here again you will use pull-down network circuit. So alternatively using NP and alternatively using NNP, 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 NNP. So that's why we call as NP CMOS or the zipper CMOS we also call it as. Okay. So this is nothing but NP CMOS logic. Okay. Right. So these simple examples I have taken here. We are given some expressions here, and we are asked to write something like circuit for using dynamic logic, NP logic, pseudo NMOS logic, and clockwork CMOS logic. Okay. Right. So dynamic logic, I told you. So we'll have two transistor PMOS and NMOS. Both will be given as one clock signal. So again, the dynamic circuits, we have a single phase dynamic circuit that we having single, which uses single clock. At the same time, we have the advanced one. We have something like the two clock, that is a double clock, phi 1 and phi 2 clocks will be using, which we call as so that actually two non-overlapping clock. So those concept will that type of circuit. So we'll study in module 5 while during explaining your memory part. Okay, I will discuss that one later part. So for right now, we can just consider single phase only. So this is your logic circuits. You will have this block here. You will realize NMOS circuit for this expression, that will become your dynamic logic. And this is your pseudo NMOS logic. You will have PMOS and ground it, and here you will just realize the NMOS logic. And your this is your NP logic. So the same dynamic circuits. So this is your N block, and the next stage what you will do is you will realize here P block, and you will take output here, the very first slide I have shown you. Okay, so that is the thing, right? Okay. The next thing is